Sammy Riggs has been waiting. In the shadows of a boarded up storefront, he's been fighting the panic of a body ravaged by the hunger for drugs he has no more money to buy. Life has become simple for Sammy. Stay high or die. Just that simple. But it takes money. And Sammy is already in debt. And the price of what he needs keeps going up. So there really isn't any choice for Sammy. So he waits, his skinny, ravaged arms wrapped around his aching chest, waiting until the drugstore across the street closes. The timing must be perfect, and his act must be Oscar material.
This is an emergency, please. I just got to get a prescription.
We close at 10, hope tomorrow at 9.
Please, mister, it's for my mother. I gotta fill this prescription, please.
Give it here.
Huh?
Come on, the prescription.
Oh, man, you're going to do it? You're beautiful. God, I can't tell you how beautiful you are for doing that.
Now come on in and let me close the door. Don't want anyone else to come in and think we're still open.
Oh, sure.
Now, let's see that prescription.
Sure. Here it is.
I knew it. I knew you'd have a gun. Take what you want and get out.
Where do you keep it?
What kind are you after? It's all locked up.
The money. Where's the money?
In a safe in the floor, set in 3 feet of concrete with a time lock. Can't be open till 9 in the morning. You're out of luck, boy.
You didn't set the time lock yet. I've been watching you from across the street. I watch you every night. You switch off the lights, then you set the time lock. So let's get the money, Pops, all of it.
No, you're wrong. You're wrong. I can't open it till 9 tomorrow morning.
Well, then I guess I'll just have to kill you.
Hey, listen, boy. Don't do that.
Listen, old man, I'm wrapped. I got a 2-hour schedule. Every 2 hours or I freak out, and it's already been 3 hours since my last hit. So you got some idea how I feel right now. Get the money. Ah! Do it!
I can't, but here. Take what's in my pocket.
Hands out of your pockets! I told him. The old jerk. It was his own fault. Let's see how much he's got on him. What's this? What's in his hand? A signal button? A wireless alarm button? I gotta get out of here!
Hey, you, stop!
Great.
Police, hold it up there!
Oh, no, they're in front of me, too.
Stop or I'll shoot!
What'll I do? They got me. Hey, a car. A car with a door open. In the alley. I can't believe this. I can't believe it.
I guess you live right, kid.
What?
Don't turn around. And both hands on the wheel. Now, what you're feeling on your neck is the muzzle of a .44 Magnum. It's awful old-fashioned, but serviceable.
What's going on?
What do you think's going on?
You're the cops, right? You were waiting for me? You planted this car?
Oh, just keep driving, Sammy. I'll tell you where to turn.
Keep driving. What do you mean, keep driving? Where are we going?
Sammy? You aren't going to believe this. You aren't going to believe any of this, Sammy, from now on.
Sammy Riggs has driven out of town, propelled by the cold nose of a gun at the base of his skull. In the hand of a man in the back seat, he still hasn't seen, except for an arm which reached over the seat and into his jacket and relieved him of his own gun. Now, defenseless and growing weaker by the minute as his body cries out for a fix, Sammy urges the big sedan through the dripping blackness of a rainy night on a narrow road that twists as it climbs into the hills.
Do you have to keep that gun where I can feel it?
Are you giving you a headache? Yeah, I bet it is. How do you feel otherwise, Sammy?
Not so hot. And how come you know my name?
I was sent to get you.
And you are a cop. But if you're a cop, where are we going?
Just keep driving. Now turn where I tell you.
So how come you know my name?
The abbot told me.
The who?
The abbot.
Who's that?
He's who he is.
What kind of an answer is that?
Hey, you're pretty cocky for a guy who just got saved.
Who are you?
Call me Bud.
You a cop?
No.
Then what?
Slow down. Okay, turn here.
Listen, Bud, I'm not feeling real good.
Hey, get ready to stop.
Hey, listen. Well, what are you going to do? You're going to shoot me, right? Listen, it was a mistake back there. I didn't want to kill that old guy. I didn't mean to do it.
Okay, stop the car.
Oh, no, please.
Out of the car.
Please.
Out. Okay, turn around.
I don't want to die. I don't want to die.
Turn around. Face down the path where the headlights shine. Now, walk 20 paces down that path.
Hey, where are you going? 20 paces. 20. 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 15, 20. It's so dark I can't see a thing. Lightning. Graveyard. I'm in the middle of a graveyard.
Are you afraid of the dead, Sammy?
Who is it? Where are you?
Right here. I've been waiting for you.
Where? Place. Stones, wall, stone, floor. Let me out! I'm strapped in. I'm strapped into this bed. Let me out of here!
Oh, good morning, Sammy. Did you sleep well?
Get me out of here.
Oh, save your energy, my
you, friend. Yeah, it was you. You slugged me.
An unfortunate necessity for most to enter here, I'm afraid.
When I get loose, I'm gonna...
Oh, yes?
My gun. Oh, yeah, the guy in the car took it.
Of course.
What, he's working for you or something?
Of course.
What's your game? Why are you wearing that thing over your head?
This cassock is a symbol of my calling. And the cowl that covers my head is a part of my vestments as abbot of this monastery.
Monastery? You the head guy?
I am.
Then how about untying me so I can get off this cot?
In good time.
Don't give me this in good time. I didn't ask to come here. Your guy shoves a gun in my back and kidnaps me, and I want out.
And where will you go?
Where will I? Back to town.
Back to a life of crime and drugs?
What's it to you?
What is your habit costing you, Sammy?
Let me worry about that.
The police want to find you, Sammy.
So what else is new?
But you've killed a man. And they know who you are.
Yeah? I suppose you were there?
No, I sent Bud. Where would you be if Bud hadn't been there?
How would I know?
You'd be dead, Sammy.
Hey, how do you know so much about me?
Well, let's just say I have plans for you.
Yeah? Well, forget it. Take these straps off the bed and out.
There are no straps holding you, Sam.
Hey, what's the deal? A second ago, I was strapped in from head to foot. I couldn't move.
Let me help you off the bed.
I don't need no.
Take my arm. Pull yourself up.
Hey, what did you do to me? I'm shaking all over.
You're weak from the changes in your chemistry, Sammy.
Chemistry? Yes. Hey, where's my watch? What'd you do with my clothes? What's this thing I'm wearing?
Your monk's habit? You won't be needing your old clothes or your watch.
Well, what time is it? I gotta have a...
Yes, Sammy? You were saying?
Wait a minute. I feel funny. I feel...
Lightheaded?
Yeah.
It will pass.
Nah, you don't know. I got a two-hour habit. If I don't get a hit every 2 hours, I go nuts.
But you don't have that old habit anymore. The only habit you have now is... the cassock you're wearing.
Funny, very funny. But you don't knock a habit like this overnight.
Quite true. When do you think you came here?
Last night.
You came here exactly 60 days ago.
2 months? I've been out of it for 2 months? How? Why?
You needed a change of life, Sammy. We gave it to you. Now, take my arm, stand up. We're going to walk a bit.
Wait a minute. Let me get this straight. You mean I'm not a junkie anymore? No more crack?
Exactly. You're a new man.
You're saying I'm clean?
Physically, yes.
Then I don't need to hang out here anymore, right? Hey, give me my clothes back and I'll clear out.
And go back to your old ways? No, Sammy. From now on, you're heading in a different direction. Come with me now.
Where are we going?
To chapel. Take a seat. There's lots of room.
I've never been in a place like this. The candles, there must be 1,000 of them. But it's still so dark. And man, is this a tall room?
Why don't you sit here in this pew? I have some duties to attend to. Perhaps you'll find something in common with the fellow you're sitting next to. He's a new arrival, too. Perhaps you've already met.
Huh? Nah, I don't think so. Of course, I can't see it too good with that, what do you call it, over your head?
Oh, you mean my cowl. I'll slip it off so you can get a better look. There. Remember me?
You? What are you doing here?
You ought to know, son. You sent me here 2 months ago.
No, you're dead. I shot you. Let me out of here. Let me out of here.
Sit here beside me, Sammy.
You've been thinking over what I said about blowing this place?
Shh. Brethren, you have been gathered here out of the world. You have been given sanctuary. But now you will begin to repay the monastery for your protection.
Uh-oh. I knew it. Here it comes.
Many of you will be given assignments for which you are well suited. But many will stay behind to receive more training.
Yeah, well, you just say the word, buddy, and I'm out of here.
We shall receive the brethren who are leaving one by one in the abbot's high chamber.
And that's it? Well, what's the deal? I want out of here. Hey! I want out of here! Give me an assignment!
Yes, Sammy?
I want to get out of here.
Is that what you want?
Yeah, that's what I want. What do you think I've been yelling about since you first dragged me up here? I want to go back!
To your old life on the street?
Yeah?
Have you been so unhappy here?
Unhappy? I don't know. It's weird here. For one thing, how come you got no windows? How come you can't see the outside? How come you stole my watch and there's no clocks anywhere?
Oh, Sammy, what a charming little dunce you are. You haven't discovered it yet.
What? Discovered what?
Here, there is no time.
No time to do what?
No time. At all. No seconds, no minutes, no hours, days, weeks, no months or years, centuries.
All right. So there's no time. I want to know something else. How come you don't feed us?
Oh, are you hungry?
Of course I'm hungry. I haven't eaten a thing since I woke up here.
And you miss food.
Listen, I may not be too big, but I used to pack away a plate of eggs and sausage and hash browns every morning. For lunch, I'd have me a big, greasy burger dripping with melted cheese and a whole mess of fries and plenty of ketchup and two or three beers. Maybe in the afternoon, I'd have me a chocolate malted. And for dinner, a steak this thick.
And that's what you want?
No. That's the thing. That's what I used to want, but now I don't. I want to want it again like I used to. All right, maybe I never really ate all that good, but I wanted it. I knew what it would taste like, and I want to want it again. But you've done something to me. And the crack. It was killing me, but for 2 hours, I'd be higher than the sky, feeling no pain. And you took that away, too.
I see.
And I used to have money, some serious walking around money to buy stuff. I even had a job once. A job. You believe it? I used to get up at 6 in the morning and run and shower off and go down to the warehouse and sweat my head off all day, and it felt good, and you took that away. I ain't done nothing for... How long have I been here?
Oh, there is no answer. There is no time.
Oh, yeah, that's right. There is no time.
Tell me something, Sammy. Suppose you could return. What would you do?
Are you kidding?
Would you live your life just as you lived it before?
No.
You wouldn't?
No, I'd stick with my job. No, I'd get a better job. I'd go back to school and study this time. Get an education. Give me a nice job someplace. Get me a girl, a nice girl. We'd have a courtship, you know? I'd bring her flowers and we'd go to dances. And I'd meet her folks. And I'd buy her a ring, a real ring. And we'd get married in a church.
The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak.
Huh?
The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak.
What's that mean?
You should know, Sammy.
Send me back!
You're not ready.
I'm not ready. Not ready for what?
Not ready for an assignment.
Yeah, what kind of an assignment? Like Bud? Like driving a big black car like you give Bud to drive? That's all he does. Give me something like that.
You're not ready.
Well, how long will it be?
There is no answer. There is no time.
No time. Here.
You!
Yes, brother?
Just tell me one thing. What year was it when you came here?
What year?
Yeah.
Funny, I can't seem to remember.
Listen, who was president? Who was in the White House?
Castleman. Castleman was president.
What are you talking about? We've never had a president by that name. I'm talking the president of the United States.
Castleman.
Another nutcase.
And she was a very pretty woman. I remember that.
Forget it. Hey, hey!
Sammy, what do you think you're doing?
Ah, my old buddy, Bud.
Hey, you're disturbing the brethren.
Oh, yeah? They're pretty disturbed already, if you ask me. I just ran into a couple of nuts. Are they all like that? Let me ask you something. Do you remember when you came here?
Oh, very clearly.
Well, how long... Nope, forget that question. What year was it when you came here?
1900.
1900 and what?
1900. Turn of the century.
Okay. You're 110?
No, I'm 30.
You came here in 1900 and you're 30.
As long as I am here, I'll be 30.
Okay, I get it. They sort of freeze time. Is that it? Nobody has a watch, no clocks on the walls. Nobody ages. Then tell me something, wise guy. How come when I woke up here, the head honcho tells me I've been here 2 months and I grew a beard? How come there was still time for me?
It took your body 2 months to throw off the chemicals you've been putting into it, Sammy, and it took mortal time for you to adjust. The same for everyone. There's an adjustment period. We give you food, less every day. Otherwise, you'd be in shock. Mental, emotional, spiritual, and physical shock.
How come I didn't find this out before?
Before what?
Before now.
There is no before. No after. Only now. The continuous now.
Listen, tell me something else. That time in the chapel when I sat down next to the old guy from the drugstore, how did you do that? I left him for dead, man.
Oh, he was dead, all right.
Look, I saw him like I see you. I was this close to him. He talked to me.
I'm talking to you.
I know you're talking to me. Well, what do you mean?
I was killed by a jealous husband who happened to come home when his wife and I thought he'd gone to Cincinnati. And you were killed by a police bullet in an alley beside a drugstore.
No, I wasn't. I wasn't touched. I saw that big black sedan sitting there, and I jumped in, and I got away clean. You were there. You were in the back seat. You held a gun on me. You took my gun. What are you trying to do, mess up my mind? I know what happened.
Oh, do you? Do you know where you are?
Do I know where? Yeah, in a monastery.
Where there is no such thing as time.
Okay, I can buy that.
There are souls here from every corner of mortality.
And crazy people. Like the guy who told me about some female president named Castleman.
Who wasn't even born when you were alive.
What? Are you saying... Are you trying to tell me there are guys from the future here?
There is no future here. No past.
Yeah, only now. Okay.
You're beginning to grasp the truth?
Yeah. I think I see.
Good.
But there's one last question.
Yes?
Why?
Yes, you're ready.
Yes, I'm ready for what?
For the answer.
So, okay, give it to me. Why? Why are there thousands...
Oh, billions.
Billions?
Yes, hundreds of billions.
All right, why are there hundreds of billions of people in this monastery?
Because the spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak.
Will you cut the double talk and answer a simple question? Why?
Perhaps I can answer that for you, Sammy. You see, here I have collected those who met life's problems with a fist instead of faith. Those who used others to get gain for themselves. Who ignored the whispers of the spirit and followed instead the flesh. Our colleague Bud is one of many who sweep the streets, trolling, as it were, for souls. They ride horses, drive carriages and automobiles and gravity vehicles wherever in time the soul in torment falls. But here, I harvest them
and turn them back to a useful sliver of mortality.
Yeah. It makes sense. I catch on now.
Excellent, Sammy. I'll admit when we began with you, we were challenged by your manner. But it will serve you very well when you are given your assignment.
No kidding?
No kidding. You are treacherous, deceitful, lustful for control over others, and willing to take innocent life and shed innocent blood. Yes, I think I have just the place for you.
Now, wait a minute. All those things you said, yeah, that's how I used to be. But, well, it was like I was telling you before. If I go back, if I could do it over again, I'd be different.
Of course.
I'd get a good education. I'd find a good job, marry a nice girl.
But you forget, Sammy. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. Farewell, Sammy. We'll meet again after you've finished your assignment.
But I... What year will it be? What time?
Hark! Listen to him, Clara. What a strong, strong voice for a newborn boy. He will make me proud. I will show him off at the government office. They will marvel that I could become a papa at the age of 50. Yeah, and we shall call him Adolf.
But the Flesh is Weak featured Wayne Shannon, Dean L. Smith, Derek Turner, Douglas Young, Merrill Mayle, and Ed Gately, with sound created by Stuart Conway and Jeff Thompson. Engineering by Bob Choi. Script and direction by yours truly, Jim French.
Imagination Theater continues after...